OpenAI has finally launched the O3 mini model, and this model is way better than the O1 model. So in their official page of OpenAI, if we scroll down, here we will be having the comparison benchmark. So as you can see here, the O3 mini model in high version is better than the O1 model as well as the O1 mini model. So this is for math competition, and if we come down, this is for PhD level science questions. Here also the O3 mini is better than the O1 model. And in terms of programming, same case, the O3 mini model is way better. So in this video, we are going to compare O3 mini model with DeepSeek's V3 as well as R1 model. So I'm having here some math problems and coding questions. So let's see which one performs well. So first, let me begin with this complex math problem. And I'm just going to copy this and paste it over here. So it's quite challenging because the way I am pasting is not exactly, you know, aligned. So it needs to like figure out what exactly is the right equation at first, and then it must solve it. So I'm just enabling the reason and I will ask it. And next I'm going for the DeepSeek's V3 model. And finally, DeepSeek's R1 model. And the correct answer for this problem is -3. Here you can see answer is B, -3. So let's see which one gives the correct answer. So as you can see here, the O3 mini model has started thinking exactly similar to DeepSeek R1. DeepSeek R1 is still thinking, whereas DeepSeek V3 has started solving the answer. Yeah. And the O3 mini is still thinking, and it has literally given the answer. DeepSeek V3 has literally given the answer, whereas O3 mini model is still figuring it out, I guess. And it has given the alpha value as -19/2, but I guess that's a wrong answer. Whereas DeepSeek's V3 has given me the right answer. So I was getting this server is busy error when I trade with DeepSeek's R1. So I got the response in another browser with DeepSeek R1, and it has found out the answer after a lot of thinking. So DeepSeek's R1 has given us the answer. DeepSeek's V3 has given us the right answer, but OpenAI's O3 mini has given us the wrong answer. I literally pasted the exact same math problem, exact same way in all the three. Yeah. So maybe you can just try solving some other problem, but this is the result that I got now. And next I'm going to try this with using a program. So this is going to be a HTML, JavaScript and CSS code that shows a ball bouncing and spinning inside a hexagon, and it needs to have gravity and friction. So I saw this prompt in Twitter. I'm just kind of modifying it with HTML, CSS and JavaScript. So let's see what each of these gives us. So we have got the response from O3 mini as well as V3 and as well as R1. So let's go step by step. And to run this, we are having the edit in canvas. So we can just click this. And this is going to be the entire code, since I asked it to give me the code in a single HTML file. So let's see what it has given us. Just click on preview. So we have got an error over here. So let me just copy this error and put it over here. I'll just stop it. And I'm using the free version of ChatGPT. So I got this error. So in the meantime, we can check for DeepSeek's V3, and we are having the run HTML over here. Click it. And this is the response that we get. You know, the ball has literally gone outside of the hexagon over here. So here you can see ball bouncing inside a hexagon. It should be affected by gravity and friction, but it has gone outside. It's entirely in the line. So we're just missing some point, but I think it's at least we got the output without any error over here. So let's see what O3 mini has given now. Yeah, it has corrected the changes, I guess. So edit in canvas and preview. So it has given me the output, and this looks perfect. This is better than V3. Look at the way the ball bounces, the gravity, the friction. This is way good. Yeah, O3 mini gave us an error at first, but after the correction, this looks splendid when compared to the DeepSeek's V3. So finally, I have got the response from DeepSeek's R1, and it literally thought for so much of time. You can literally see here, right? I gave the prompt over here. This is just for a single prompt. It's just going. Yeah, this is the prompt I gave. It literally thought for more than how many minutes? Nearly 10 minutes. It literally thought for 10 minutes. I'm not sure why it thought so much. It could be because of the traffic issues or something. But yeah, at the end, it gave me the answer response. So I'll just run this. Actually, it has quite done well with the gravity and the friction, but it has missed in providing the, like, you know, the border for the hexagon. So it's not quite there. Whereas in O3 Mini, it's been the perfect one for me. So O3 Mini wins over here. So let's just go with another prompt. So this is the final one, exactly similar to the previous one, same JavaScript, HTML and CSS. And this time I'm asking it to create a lightning effect continuously occurring on the screen with black background. So this needs to be super realistic. This is going to be my prompt. So let's just run this and try it out, the lightning effect, and preview. Okay, that's not bad at all. That's not bad, to be honest. That looks realistic. Yeah, I mean, this is just HTML and CSS and JavaScript. This is the maximum it can do. And I really like how it has replicated, you know, those imperfections at the end, you know, like the thorny things at the end. That's good. That I will give that a 10 on 10, to be honest, for this. So let's see what DeepSeek's V3 model has given. Very less code. I hope this works. I'll just run. Okay, this is not that good. I mean, yeah, this looks like a lightning, but the realism is better in O3 mini model. This is not bad, but I won't give this as a 10 on 10. This is something like a 6 out of 10. So O3 mini leads over here, and let's see what R1 has given us, and just run this. Okay, that's not bad. And yeah, I really like the imperfections here too, but the thing is, it's not realistic, you know. It's so short, and it's not exactly good, to be honest. So you just saw, right? So I think O3 mini is way better than the DeepSeek's R1 and V3 in creating this animation. So really good to see ChatGPT getting a model which is on par with DeepSeek's R1. And I'm super excited to see how the O3 model is going to behave. This is just the O3 mini model, and it's already on par and in some cases better than DeepSeek's R1. So just imagine the O3 model. And please let me know your opinion in the comments. I hope you would have found this video useful, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in DeepSeek, Qwen, AI tools, CRUD operations, Sora, ChatGPT and stuff. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.